There's a very important concept that has come about in cancer research and care in the last few years, and it's this idea of the tumor microenvironment. How not just the tumor cells or changes in the tumor cells themselves, but every cell around the tumor that contributes to the tumor changing can be measured and used to try to predict how that tumor will behave going forward. The tools we have at our disposal are maturing very rapidly. For example, the chemical imaging tools, very sophisticated microscopy tools, very sophisticated in vivo imaging tools, machine learning or artificial intelligence, and now we're moving towards 3D measurement. So in principle, you could measure in three dimensions what every single cell is doing in response to a tumor growing or not. And that's where the power of prediction is likely going to come, because you're looking at all the information as opposed to just looking at the tumor itself. There are far too many measurements, far too many cell types, too many chemical changes that can happen for us to reliably take a small number of samples from humans and try to abstract out that information. And you cannot really ask what-if questions. You cannot say, if only this cell had moved a certain distance away or had a different molecular profile, what would happen? So to answer those kinds of questions, you need model systems. So that's why we got interested in 3D printing, is to build this bottom-up approach where we can take a cell culture and actually engineer little scaffolds and try to grow cancer cells within that confined space. And if we can do that, then we can perhaps print out the right geometry and grow cells to make realistic designer tumor models in the lab. The next perhaps crucial step is, how do we get cells to grow along those scaffolds that we've generated? And that's what we're working on now. We will never be able to recapitulate exactly everything that might go on in a human body with tumor models. But having models that are closer, perhaps, to the human condition will certainly allow us to access problems that may not arise in two-dimensional cultures. For example, how does a cell invade into the microenvironment is not possible really to study with two-dimensional cultures in great detail. So there's some fundamental questions that will be answered with these new models. There's some clinical insight that we can gather with these models. And of course, the challenge is to make them. So we think the future ideal system can be one in which we can get patient cells and very rapidly synthesize these 3D tumor models that reasonably accurately reflect what's going on with the patient. And then we can use individualized drugs to treat these tumors and perhaps get at more individual treatment regimens.